Mr. President, fellow commissioners, county employees, and citizens of Carroll County, I appreciate having time this afternoon to reflect on what we have done together over 8 years, to share some concerns, to thank some people, and offer a few parting thoughts as the county readies for the transition to the 61st Board of County Commissioners. In many ways, time has flown. It is hard to believe that when I was sworn in, my youngest son was 7, and today he stands notably taller than I am, which I understand is not a huge accomplishment. I am proud that the 59th board was the first board of 5 commissioners by district. As president of the board for the first 3 years, I had the awesome opportunity to help define how we govern, develop new processes, and shape this and future boards. We started on day one, with our 10 governing principles, and to those we stayed committed. Starting our meetings with a pledge and a prayer, term limits, tax reduction, property rights, economic development, and straight talk all became the hallmark of how we have governed even up to today. After some heated discussions, I suggested we add Positively Carroll as a way to focus not only on the difficult and the divisive, but also on the good happenings in our community, and that has continued to be a regular agenda item. Together, over 8 years, we have done quite a bit. Commissioner Rothschild mentioned many of these items on Tuesday. This is what I recall. We started with the transition to the Sheriff's Office for law enforcement. We stopped the incinerator project. We fought for the right to pray at meetings. We fought against Plan Maryland and the rain tax. We partnered with our municipalities, including on major and challenging things like the MPDES projects. We built Mount Airy Middle School. We passed a county master plan that strongly recognized property rights. We invoked the right place and the right time as our economic development message and had an unprecedented period of time of economic development progress due to the great work of that department and our director there. We significantly reduced county debt, we reduced taxes 3 times, and we finished our term with a AAA bond rating. During that period of time, we had the creation of various advisory groups, the Solid Waste Advisory Group, a Business Advisory Group, the Combined Education Committee, the Long-Term Advisory Council, and the Veterans Advisory Council, all using citizens to bring ideas to the table, not high-priced consultants, but people that were invested in our community, and they have served us so well. During that period of time, we also had the opportunity to lead the fight on some controversial issues, things where we really could have gone either way as a community. The idea of increasing school funding and not pursuing a path of maintenance of effort, leading to things like teacher raises and the resources that we put into schools, was something that today seems just part of the discussion, but back early on was pretty controversial. The airport expansion, we were on and then we were off and then back on again. And we know the challenges and the discussions that went into that. And even the Public Safety Training Center in its first iteration only passed by a 3-2 vote, and it really required us to hash some things out in those early days. I also had an awful lot of fun and take probably the most pride in things that we had the ability to initiate, things that weren't here but we created. The opportunity to implement E-Verify for our county contractors, Celebrating America and the Summer Explorer Program, Carroll 2030, as we saw earlier today, a new website, a marketing campaign, the Small Business Loan Program, Not in Carroll, our effort against drugs, Sunday hours at libraries, our veteran services officers that have garnered more than $10 million in benefits for our Carroll County veterans, and the veteran shuttle that we aptly named Mad Dog after Mad Dog Sader, who inspired that effort. And those that related specifically to my district, things like the extension of Dickinson Road. I would never have imagined early on how difficult it was to get those last 30 or 40 feet of road done, but it was a big deal. Stop signs and traffic issues, transition of the Carrolltown Mall, projects with the town of Sykesville, the Warfield Project, and last but certainly not least, the Freedom Plan. All in all, I believe that together we have accomplished a great deal, managed through some challenging times, met the needs of our community, and did it in a fiscally responsible way, leaving the county in a strong position moving forward. With the ability to take on these challenges and move the county forward, that rests largely on the extraordinary people that we have chosen, to work for Carroll County government. From time to time, you hear the names, Zaleski, Kay, Frock, Burke, the other Burke, Castingway, Campbell, Ripper, Deggets, Devilbiss, and yes, Liburn. They are very talented, committed, and hardworking folks that lead the day-to-day workings of our government. To me, their names should be emblazoned on the backs of shirts and should be recognized as an all-star team of county government, the very, very best in the state of Maryland. Pulling all this together was the exceptional team that supports the county commissioners directly. The entire staff contributes in ways big and small to keep our office moving productively. Roberta Windham started at the county as my administrative support and quickly demonstrated that drive, talent, and leadership skills that make her an excellent county administrator. Chris Weinbrenner works each day to improve the dialogue between county government and our citizens and has the challenging task of communicating what we do in a way that is anything but boring. And Vivian Daly, who has worked by my side, coordinated programs and my crazy schedule, making sure we got to it all. Ladies, I could not have done a fraction of what I did without your support and your talent and your hard work. Now, not surprisingly, I have some areas of concern, some of which might be slightly controversial. I am very pleased that Governor Hogan was overwhelmingly reelected. He is moving Maryland in the right direction, and his efforts should be strongly supported. At the same time, the governor's relationship with Carroll County must be stronger and more direct in the next 4 years. Our board president should have the level of contact and access enjoyed by county executives in other counties. And it must be recognized by the governor and his administration that it is Carroll County government that speaks for the county, not our state delegation. The accountability of laws, staffing, budget, and consequences rests with the Board of Commissioners, and that's who should be communicating the needs and our priorities. With regards to our delegation, those that reside in Carroll and those that represent just a small portion, we need our county priorities, as identified by the Board of Commissioners, to drive the legislative activity and focus of the Carroll County delegation in Annapolis. The days of picking and choosing certain initiatives that are politically expedient or easier must end. The days of success being defined by making bad legislation less bad must end. Our delegation must balance their excitement of being part of Team Hogan and Carroll with remembering their primary role is to represent Carroll County as a whole in a hostile legislature. Those that want to criticize, second guess, or even interfere with the work of county government with no accountability for the outcome should be more focused on building support for the initiatives we need. They should govern themselves with the same standard of open meetings held in the county, two-term limits, that they have supported for other folks, and we should never encourage anybody to be serving a third or fourth, and certainly not a fifth term. I will say that one shining star in our delegation is Senator Justin Reedy. Senator Reedy is always engaged, open to new ideas, and willing to bring them forward. We did not always agree, but even with caller ID, he took many of my calls, heard me out, and worked collaboratively to enhance our causes. He is the strength we should lean on and will be a fixture in Maryland politics for a long time to come, in my opinion. Citizens should be wary of county, state, local officials that tell them they can have it all without cost or consequence. Some of the community challenge we have are grounded in the fact that arrogance or inability or unwillingness to be honest and straightforward with the community has caused some challenges. The death knell for North Carroll High School was sounded when the first shovel dug in to build Manchester Valley. And even today, good options that could save that property that are being worked on very difficultly, possibly the building and enhance the community, are being squandered by those that are clinging to false hope. I think it is time to put the ownership of that building in the hands of the town and contribute a comparable amount to what it would cost to demolish it, some $1.5 million for something we don't want to see happen, to help the town find a real solution that meets their needs and let them make the decision. I strongly believe that as reality sets in, a real solution will be found. And we can only hope that such reality finds its way to the Board of Education. I am very encouraged that some of those elected and some already there have the ability, perspective, and stated goals of making the Board of Education more focused on student achievement, less dependent on standardized testing, more efficient in its operations, and more transparent in its work. The real question is whether or not they will truly take action in those areas. Carroll County Public Schools are very good, but they have been in decline because of a top-heavy administration that gives too much deference to the unions, the state of Maryland, and educational organizations. Our system simply must derive its mission from the citizens of Carroll County and embrace those strategies that enhance student achievement, stop being the arbiter of community issues, and deliver the very best education in Maryland within our financial boundaries. And yet, even with these concerns, I believe the future of Carroll County has such tremendous potential and will continue to be bright. In fact, I believe we might well be that shining city on a hill to which Ronald Reagan often referred. Going forward, we will rely on the 61st Board to build on the foundations we have established and bring Carroll County to new heights. Education must remain a priority. The new board should seek to quickly bring the Board of Education and the delegation to the table before union negotiations are done and before the legislative session begins. If the Board of Ed overcommits and there is no additional state funding, there will only be one place for the difference to rest. As the county funding for local schools approaches 60%, the conversations must bring a measure of reality to all sides. To that end, there should be a commitment by the Board of Education to line up facility needs with the county capital plan. Pretending there is money when there more money than there actually is and asking for the moon gets in the way of setting true priorities. The discussion about buildings and budgets must give way to a community-wide discussion about improving school performance. Infrastructure must also be a priority. The cost of maintaining all of the buildings, roads, facilities, and other obligations is very high. The County Office of Budget and Management is working diligently on a break-even number, essentially what we need to be doing each year in infrastructure just to maintain what we have. I encourage them to bring that analysis, even if it is still broad in measure, to the next budgeting process and continually measure our progress in this area. The scourge of drugs in our community must also remain a high priority. Our initial Not in Carroll effort to dissuade drug dealers from setting up in Carroll County as a safe place to sell drugs was met with extraordinary effort by our state's attorney's office, the sheriff's department, and related agencies. In later years, this effort was expanded to be more broadly support treatment and education. We must commit whatever resources we can to this effort. The tragic loss of life impacted almost every family, and the community problems that result must make this one of our top efforts. This year, the budget debate, to my discredit, wrongly got lost between the issue of this and ag preservation. Next year, as we did some years ago, I would strongly encourage to take an amount off the top to make of available funds before the remainder of the budget is funded. This is a fight we must continue to fight. It should also be a priority to stay committed to long-term planning. So much of what the Board of Commissioners does year in and year out has long-term implications for the community. My first effort, Carroll 2030, brought some very interesting information and trends to light. Those that participated did an amazing job to give us a long-term picture, agency by agency. Our most recent effort, the Long-Term Advisory Council, had similar participation from community leaders and brought out important considerations for the next board. It is unfortunate that LTAC lost some direction as it was let to go down a politicized path. Ironically, that was the criticism of Carroll 2030. And yet it is my strong hope that the challenges of long-term planning in this or in our master planning process, the burden of time and resources, and the controversy it can yield never inhibit us from looking to the future, deciding the direction for our community, and working each day to make that a reality. As Abraham Lincoln said, the best way to predict the future is to create it. Finally, I encourage this next board to pursue all of this and more, but with the same fiscal responsibility that we have embraced for 8 years. Stay committed to balancing the 5-year operating plan, something unique to Carroll County. While addressing capital needs, work to keep our county debt low. Seek a cost-benefit analysis on not only new initiatives, but the continuation of initiatives as priorities change. Look for ways to deliver services in a more lean and cost-effective way, using creativity over capital when possible. And make the commitment to avoid any increase in tax rates over the next 4 years and look for opportunities to lessen tax burdens whenever possible. Leaving with a AAA bond rating tells me not only did we get a lot done, but we did it in a fiscally responsible manner. In closing, the most revered words whenever I have the podium, I would like to personally thank some folks and then wrap up. First and foremost, I want to thank my wife, Crystal Weinbrenner. She joined the fray in the midst of a chaotic time and has been a tremendous support. She is tough, vocal, and has demonstrated great talent in her area of transportation that serves so many in need every day. She is amazing. Next, I want to thank my six children and two stepdaughters. I could not be prouder. With the graduation of my fourth oldest next year from college, we will have two teachers, a successful businessman, and a scientist, one graduating school, and three more in Carroll County schools. I know it was challenging to have me in the Carroll County Times, at your school, or on billboards during your formative years, and yet each of you are thriving in your own way. I want to thank my mom, Edwina Howard, who is 77 and still managing a dozen souvenir stores in Boston, who remains an avid fan of any and all Boston sports teams. On my feistiest days, I am the best reflection of her drive and passion and unending energy. And to my sister Jackie, who is my daily confidant, therapist, and voice of encouragement. They, along with family and friends, have made this journey so much more fun and certainly more successful. I want to thank my fellow commissioners from this board and the last. I believe they have all come to the job with a love for Carroll County and a desire to serve. In days of agreement, we made each other stronger. And in days of debate and disagreement, we made each other stronger. The open debate in full view of the public allowed us to set better policy, and that is what government should be. And I also want to congratulate and extend my support to Commissioners-elect Rothstein and Boucher and wish them the very best. I want to thank many, many leaders across the county and the state that I had the opportunity to work with, learn from, and collaborate. While there are too many to list, people like Mike McMullen, Karen Merkel, Alan K. Betts, Tom White, and especially Lynn Wheeler all offered support, counsel, and guidance, and so I thank you. Finally, I want to thank a man who today is in our midst that has stood by me through it all. From the first days of the first campaign through today, Bob Leatherwood is a sixth-generation Carroll Countyan, a successful businessman, an Eagle Scout, a great political mind, and the most loyal friend anyone could ever ask for. We have had thousands of hours of debate and discussion, and many of my most interesting ideas came from those discussions, though the publicly only saw the refined versions of those ideas. Thank you, Bob. I will miss being County Commissioner for Carroll County in District 5. I have tried to meet every issue with a true focus on what I believe to be best for the county. And while the best of intentions ideas must face the challenges of implementation and reality, there are always things that could have been done better. And yet, I am so proud of what we have done, so confident about where we are heading, and so thankful for all of those that helped. May God continue to protect and bless Carroll County and those who serve her. This will be my last session as commissioner, but I will always stand ready to serve Carroll County if called upon to do so, as we pursue new challenges and greater heights. There is so much more to do, and our best days truly lie ahead. As George Bernard Shaw wrote and Robert Kennedy quoted many times during his last campaign, some men see things as they are and say why. I dream things that never were and say why not. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.